Up until this point, we have been working on developing our package. In the next couple of lessons, I want to focus on hooking up our package to a local, fresh Laravel installation that we can do some testing on. So what I've actually done is I've created a brand new Laravel application. This is a totally fresh Laravel application. The only thing I did was I ran Laravel new press-blog. That's it. I didn't do anything else. So let's start modifying this to serve our needs. Open up the composer.json file and let's modify this to work. Now, what we want to do is we want to be able to bring in our package. One option that you have is you can put your package up in GitHub and then push all your commits to it and then keep coming back to this application and run composer update. But that is very inefficient. So we're going to hook up our composer.json file to our local package, and we're actually going to symlink our actual package directory right into our vendor directory. It almost works like magic, and it's really, really easy to do. So let's get started. So you add a new entry called repositories. Inside there, we'll add a new object. It's going to be dev-package. Inside there, we'll add yet another object, and we got to put a couple of parameters here. First off, type, which we're going to specify through a path. Second of all, we're going to add a URL. And now this URL is going to be the direct path in your local machine. I'm on a Mac, so it all starts with users, and then you got to find your user, right? In my case, this is victor/documents/code/press. Now that is going to change from machine to machine. You're going to have to look it up for your own macOS installation. Now I do want to show you a really easy way to find this. So in the terminal, you want to find the direct path to this. And to do that, you do pwd for present working directory. And there it is, users, victor, documents, code, press. And that's exactly what I had put in my composer.json file. And lastly, we're going to add an option. And the option that we're going to add is that symlink option that we spoke about. So symlink, and we're going to set that equal to true. And I have another tab open here with my press blog. So this is my actual fresh Laravel installation. And I'm simply going to run composer require vicconvt/press. Now this command would have failed had I not made the composer.json modifications that we just did. But now, there it is. So it has brought in our package and it has symlinked it from our local package. Now the beauty of this is that I can continue to work directly on our package and every update is automatically put in. Now I do want to show you in Finder what that actually looks like. In Finder, I'm inside my press blog project. Remember, this is the Laravel project that I'm creating for testing. Inside my vendor directory, I'm going to scroll down to V, and there it is. And there is our package right there, installed. However, if you notice, it is actually an alias right here. And an alias is just a shortcut. Now, if I actually double click on this, we end up back in our package. Victor, documents, code, and press. So this has actually simply symlinked our local package into our test Laravel application. And that is really powerful. That's what's really going to allow us to have a really nice flow. Let's add one more thing. I'm going to jump back to PHP Storm. So for the rest of this video, I'm going to be using PHP Storm for our package and Sublime for our test dummy application. Now, one of the newest package features in Laravel is package auto discovery. Before this auto discovery feature was brought into Laravel, you had to manually register your service providers with your application. But now everything gets hooked up automatically. So I definitely want to set up auto discovery for our package. It's very simple to do, so let's get started. In my composer.json file, inside our package, at the very end, I'm going to add a new line, extra. Let's set extra to an object with another key of Laravel, and inside Laravel, another object, and then providers. And inside there, we're going to have an array. Now this will have our service providers. Now what you're going to put inside providers is the namespace of the provider, not the path. So that may get a little confusing, but it's the namespace. In my case, vicconvt press base service provider. Again, to repeat that one more time, what's inside here is our namespace. If you go to the press service provider, we look at the namespace, obviously vic.vt / press plus the class name, press base service provider. And there it is. And just like that, our package can now be auto-discovered. Let's see that in action. Now to see this auto-discovery magic happen, let's remove our package and then add it back in. Composer, remove, vic.vt / press. So that command will remove our package, and let's go ahead and require back in. Composer, require, vic.vt / press. And there it is. Our package has been auto-discovered, and we see it down here. So with this simple extra field that we added to our composer.json file, our package is going to be able to hook up directly into any Laravel application that it gets required into. And that makes using a package extremely easy. And there is no additional manual setup needed to start using our package.